Hi everyone, this is Clemmy Games and welcome to the Indie Game Backlog. This week, we will take a look at TikTok Tower, an arcadey platformer by the developer Sneaky Mammoth and released on Steam in September 2015. First things first, great name for a developer. TikTok Tower currently sits on a mostly positive rating on Steam, with some complaints with regards to the control scheme. However, there was a recent patch in July 2016 which updated the controls, and personally I did not have any issues with it. As a platformer, the objective is to get to the end of the level, but the catch here is that you only have 10 seconds to complete each level. It then becomes a mad dash to the exit, and this repeats over and over until you fail a level. The total number of levels completed will then be your score for the run, posting to a global leaderboard. In general, I am not a fan of timers in games, as I feel that this may take away from the experience of a game as the player becomes too focused on the main objective and hence not stop to smell the flowers. However, the 10-second rule here is built into the core of this game, and it is just the right amount of time in my opinion as compared to, say, a game that gives you 60 minutes of time to complete the game. I found the fast-paced action in this game to be really satisfying, as it was go 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 all the time. You had to quickly assess the map, and then execute on your plan of action to get to the exit, all within a span of 10 seconds. Levels in this game are not procedurally generated, but rather are picked from a pool of levels, and during the course of this playthrough, I did see quite a number of repeats. However, the aspect of the randomness that I liked the most were the different tweaks made to your perspective as the game moved from level to level. There were levels with obscured vision due to lack of light, inverted levels, levels which had the camera tilted about 30 degrees, and even levels with a zoomed in or out perspective, which made for a challenging experience as I had to quickly adjust and adapt to the changing situations. Obstacles in the levels included spikes, moving platforms, vanishing platforms, directional signs which sped up your characters, and even turrets, which meant plenty of challenge there. On top of the core goal of getting to the next level, there are also coins and stopwatches scattered about on each level. Collecting coins allowed you to purchase additional characters, while the stopwatch itself added 2 seconds to the clock on the next level, meaning that you now had 12 seconds instead of 10 to complete the level. While you could simply aim for the exit at each level, these collectibles are a risk-reward type mechanic designed such that the player must make a decision on the spot on whether or not to go for these. Each available character does also control slightly differently based on their statistics. While I mainly played with the default character with the default stats, I can see how mastering each character would be fun, and the high score chase is always there for you to compete globally. As a side note, the main character from another indie game in Tesla Grad is also available in TikTok Tower, which is a nice little crossover for fans of indie games. There are also a number of modes in the game, with what I have mentioned thus far applying to arcade mode. Hardcore mode is similar to arcade mode, but it adds in more difficult levels, while time attack mode is where you try to complete as many levels as possible in 60 seconds, with each stopwatch adding 5 seconds to your timer. There are also a multitude of multiplayer modes which I did not delve into. All that being said, I did have a pretty fun time with TikTok Tower due to its fast-paced platforming action. Anyway, that will do it for this video. If you enjoyed it, please don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. Leave a comment if you like. Thanks again, and I will see you in the next video.